Previously on Alienated.
Until we know what's going on, we're staying at a motel.
She refuses to have sex with me because the aliens made my sperm glow orange.
I think since Isabella's the only one who hasn't been abducted, that she should be the one who has to leave.
Hey, I wasn't taking pity on you.
I bet you say that to all the new kids at school.
I have to go. My parents are waiting.
No. Don't go, please. Just another hour.
Why is Miss Meyer still waiting outside?
Just ignore her.
You were abducted, sweetie. We saw it.
There, the Man Cup playoffs continue tonight. Game time's at 8 p.m. at the Archie Browning Sports Center in Esquimalt. The Victoria Shamrocks currently lead the series 2-0. In Major League Baseball now, Toronto completed a three-game sweep with an 8-0 win over Detroit. The Tigers' 15th shutout loss.
Isabel?
Belle?
Are you all right? Break it down.
What?
Marnie, what's going on?
Didn't you hear it?
What?
Isabel's scream?
Yeah.
Roger, break it down.
You're gonna break down the door?
But she screamed.
Well, so? I mean, she's always screaming. She's a girl.
Yeah, and now she's not answering.
Well, maybe she's not there. It's only been 2 days. Why would the aliens take her again so soon?
Break it down, Roger.
Okay. Here I go.
Don't you dare come in! Just go away, all of you.
Abnormal frequencies are rattling my mind. There's no mistaking, this thing is shaking me up inside. Sometimes it feels a bit peculiar standing in the crowd. Been my experience, too much interference to bring it down. So can you feel it? Spread your wings. Spread your wings.
Isabel. Sweetie, come on now, open the door.
Go away.
Did the aliens take you again?
No. Worse.
Okay. Well, she's obviously fine. I have to get to work.
Roger.
You know what's going to happen to me if I miss another day of work? Fine.
Well, I'm outside. I'm coming up.
Don't you dare!
I'm coming up now.
Honey?
Can't you just leave me alone?
Apparently not.
Don't come any closer.
Roger? Did you get in?
And don't let her in. I don't want anyone to see me.
It can't be that bad.
It's hideous. I'm hideous.
Roger!
You're starting to freak me out a bit, Belle. Now, they haven't switched your head with somebody else's, have they? Or given you an animal's head?
Dad.
Okay, look, I'm just gonna pull back the covers.
No!
I have to, or I have to let your mom in here, and she's gonna do it. So, why don't you just give me an idea of what I'm going to see?
It's my face, okay?
Oh, boy. Okay, well, let's take a look.
Okay, there! Are you happy?
There's nothing wrong with you.
Don't try to tell me you don't see it! See what? What is going on?
There's nothing wrong with her.
There is so! Look at it! It's huge!
I can't believe what you just put us through! I'm going to work.
You guys getting a good look?
It's not that bad, sweetie. Right, Cameron? Cameron.
What?
A pimple. It's not that bad, right?
That's a pimple? It could just be some sort of boil. Or maybe a goiter.
A goiter? It is not a goiter. It's just a pimple.
Can you see out of it?
You know what? You are not being very helpful. Why don't you go to school?
She's not getting out of another day of school because of this, is she?
You're damn right.
I didn't get to miss school after I was abducted.
That's because you wouldn't admit that you had been abducted.
Well, she's not going, neither am I, because I've got my own problems.
You are both going to school. Mom, look at me. What am I supposed to do? Are you going to pay for a makeup artist to come over here?
No, don't be silly. Makeup isn't going to cover that.
Shine like the sun for me, baby. What's with the hair?
I got a zit.
Big deal, I got like 20 zits.
No, this one's different. It's huge.
It can't be that bad.
It's bad.
Let me see.
No way.
Hello, this is me you're talking to. And when I say I love everything about you, I mean I love everything about you. Oh my God.
Charlie!
At least your hair covers it. And it's gonna go away.
Don't be so sure.
What do you mean? Why wouldn't it go away?
Excuse me.
Isabel?
Hi, neighbor.
Hey.
Isn't it weird that our lockers are right next door to each other? We never even talked.
Yeah.
I mean, that's crazy. You should come over to my locker sometime.
Whoa.
Something? Something you need to tell me?
No. I don't know. I was just being silly. You're stupid. I'm sorry. Seriously. Okay?
Okay. I gotta hit lunch. See you at lunch?
Yeah.
Don't be like this. I just don't see any other way to preserve the long-term prospects of our relationship.
Can't believe I'm getting dumped by a 14-year-old.
It's not like that. You know how I feel about you, but you just don't seem to realize the risk that you're putting us in by acting the way you do. I mean, first you show up at my house without any warning, and then the other night at the motel.
I thought you enjoyed that.
No, the other motel, where I was staying with my family. You waited out in the parking lot for 6.5 hours. Sooner or later, someone is going to figure out what's really going on. And that's why I think it would be best if we stopped seeing each other. Just for a few years.
No, you know what? You're right. I can do this. I can live without you. Oh my God, I can't. I can't live without you.
No, no, you have to try. It'll be worth it. The time apart will only make our eventual reunion.
If you're gonna go, just go. And don't come back.
I've got you for English right after lunch.
Well, then don't come back until then.
You a serious kid. Is that because you have such a serious name, Kent?
I'm not so serious.
Yeah? You like to have fun?
Sure.
Why don't you tell me what you like to do for fun, Kent? You like to play frisbee with your friends here?
Isabel?
Or do you like to take a girl out and show her a good time?
Isabel.
Hi, Julie.
What are you doing?
I'm talking to my new friend, Kent.
I was just sitting here and she
Kent
just
happens
talking.
To be my boyfriend. So maybe you should just back off.
Ouch. Talk about serious. I think someone needs to go on a diet and lighten up.
Excuse me? Isabel.
No, Julie, I think we should go.
Yeah, let's go.
He was talking to me, a little skank. Hey, she's not a skank.
Come on, let's go.
She's not even interested in him. Doesn't look that way to me.
Yeah, doesn't look that way to me either. Does it, Kent?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
They're trying to help you?
I don't want your help.
Fine.
You're not leaving, are you, Kent?
Yeah, we're leaving. Nice hair, by the way.
Yeah, nice breasts. Where'd you buy them?
You bitch!
Just had a bad day, that's all. I mean, she woke up this morning with a pimple on her forehead, and that set her off. You know how kids are with their appearance.
It's a little more serious than that. I was hoping she was just drunk, but after talking to her, it became clear to me that this was something else.
You mean drugs?
No. I think we're dealing with a sudden and quite serious behavioral problem, and I'm concerned that if it goes unchecked, it might lead to the onset of UPS.
UPS?
Unremitting promiscuity syndrome.
So you're saying that she's suddenly become curious about sex?
Oh, I think he's saying more than that, dear. I think he's saying that she's horny and that she's a slut.
He is not.
He is too, and it is totally uncalled for. Our daughter is not a horny slut.
I did not call her a horny slut.
She got into a fight, for God's sakes. What has that got to do with whether or not she's promiscuous?
Promiscuous.
Whatever.
She made unwanted advances on a boy in the presence of his girlfriend.
Unwanted advances? She hit on a guy. Big deal. This kind of stuff happens all the time. This is high school, in case you've forgotten. I swear, you people, you analyze and reanalyze, and then you attach syndromes to every move they make. I'm really getting fed up with it.
She hit on me.
Oh. Well, that's a little different.
Yes.
You didn't.
Of course not.
Roger!
Well, you never know these days. You read the papers.
You don't have anything to worry about in that regard. What you need to worry about is the degree to which she is making these advances. Now, I can't explain it, only to say that she gives off this aura that is very unnerving.
Oh, boy.
And it's hard not to draw a comparison to what happened last term with your son, Cameron. If you recall, the pattern was the same. He got into a fight, there was a sudden behavior change, which was amorous in nature. So I can't help but wonder, what is going on with this family?
That's a good question. And, you see, the thing you need to know about us is that we're very sexual people. What I mean is that we come from a line of people who are sexual.
Sexual people?
Not both of us. It's actually Roger's side of the family. I'm not very sexual.
That's true.
Sex is just in their blood, you see? Like Latin people. Obviously, it's been passed on to our children, and like Cameron, Isabel's just going through the initial adjustment phase. You know, I can assure you that in a matter of days, these urges will be under control.
Though most of you chose very interesting topics to write about and put in a reasonable effort, there is one person who seemed to miss the point of the exercise altogether. I mean, how hard can it be to grasp the notion of socialism in Elizabethan literature? And what is even more amazing is that this same person can't even spell. He spelled ignominiously I-G-N-O-M-I-N-I-O-U-S-L-E-Y.
Okay. Oh. Could you just move your hair to the side so I can see it?
Wouldn't it be more fun if you did it for me?
Just show it to him, Isabel.
What a grump. Not you, you're cute.
It's Carter, right?
That's right.
That's a sexy name.
I like it.
Whoa. Hey, hey, that's enough.
You see? That's not normal, is it?
It's okay, sweetie.
Fascinating.
Yeah, we get the picture.
But
time to go.
I'll be right back. Is she going to be okay?
If what happened with Cameron is any indication, then I think so. And it may take her a little more time to bring this under control, because obviously the aliens have taken a more aggressive approach with her, but essentially we're dealing with the same situation.
Well, we just need to make sure that they don't have any kind of sexual contact, because that's what the aliens want, right? Is for us to have sex?
Clearly.
Yeah, but why can't we have sex? I mean, her tubes are tied, there's no problem.
We are not having sex!
How come she's not like Isabel? Why didn't they make her, you know,
a horny slut?
No. Yes.
So it's official. I'm a freak, right? I'm not ever going back to school, that's for sure.
You're never leaving the house.
No, hang on. We can't keep her prisoner here.
Of course we can.
She has to be able to go out and she has to go to school. Isabel, it doesn't have to be this way. You can fight it.
How?
The same way that your father did. He had the same urges that you do, and he managed to control them. Didn't you?
Yes.
Tell her how.
It's worst when I'm in a public place and I see a woman. A beautiful woman, and I'm overcome with the urge to take her in my arms and...
Just tell her how you stop the urge.
I think about your mother. I mean, I think about being with your mother instead of that woman. You see what I'm saying?
I'm trying not to.
The thing is, it takes a lot of willpower. You really have to focus yourself on that one thing and nothing else. And that's not always so easy. Especially when it's been so long, you can't always remember what it is you're supposed to be picturing.
Isabel? There is another way as well that we need to talk about. It's the physical route.
You mean exercise?
No. Masturbation.
Whoa!
Mother!
Jesus.
What? We need to talk about it.
Well, not with me here. I can't believe this.
Well, leave us alone then.
Fine.
No! I don't want to talk to you about that. I've got way more information than I need to fight this now. Okay, I'll take it from here. God. Hi.
Hey.
Look, I'm really sorry, okay?
For what?
Charlie.
Look, you know how I thought you were. Let's just leave it at that.
No, I am. Really. I was abducted by aliens.
You think this is funny?
But it's true. They've taken everyone in my family. They gave me this zit, which is the reason I'm attracted to guys. Gives off some kind of signal to them. But I can control it now. Just give me a chance to prove it to you.
Hey, John! Wait up!
See something you like?
No, wait! I controlled it, didn't you see? I thought about you!
What's with her?
Oh, nothing. What's with her?
Oh, nothing.
School sucks.
Totally.
Next time on Alienated.
Wait a minute, I recognize you.
No, I doubt that.
Didn't you play Sulu on the original Star Trek?
Nope.
Yeah, you did. It's George Takei.
Okay, yes, I am.